understand you well, that what you have in the model you have in the super house now is some form of public-private partnership, the form we know from Berlin and other towns. And it always is the same model, that the private come in and they have 10% of the management, so they change the whole structure and logic of the company. If I understood this right. And second, I think we should use a little bit our time to think if what we at the European movement can do to support you. Because you are here today, I think we should concentrate more on this now. We don't have so much time anymore.
In a way, there are two models combined. The one is the power, it's a hidden public-private partnership inside through the sale of the 11% of the company. Let's not forget that part of the company is already sold. So by finishing this 11% sale, it will be something like 50% plus one stock remaining to the state. This is just to be on the safe side when it comes to the Supreme Court decision. But in reality, the super fund is a new mechanism. Where here we have a novelty. The super fund is a way to actually privatize public assets in general. The old model was Treuhand in the years of the uniting of the two Germanies back in the that time. Then there is, let us say, something also similar in France with the Participation à l'État, there is this fund where there is the public participations in France. These are, let us say, explorative things that they do. In the case of Greece, they have, let us say, terminated the whole thing. They just put everything inside this new super fund. It's a way of actually financializing and privatizing and in general facilitating their grab of the public sector. So here, there we have a novelty in the case of Greece, something that everybody should be careful to look at, because as you know, these are experiments. Today they're implemented in Greece, tomorrow they will be implemented, unfortunately, to some other countries.